she'll be cut out.
Exactly. They eat grits in Sacramento. I love grits, but
listen, where you from?
I'm from here, from Sacramento originally. Yeah.
The whole grits thing, I thought maybe you was from the South.
She from Compton.
You know what
good
I mean?
Good morning, good morning. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Jesus Christ, she got to swallow that.
Where's your cup, Percy? I didn't see your cup.
I'm waiting for us to show up, but it's...
It's a delay.
We are delayed.
Oh, that's going to be a problem. Ooh.
We're seeing what's happening here. Huh. It's coming up slowly but surely.
All right. You got to show all your teeth, Mark.
Because that's what I got. I got a mouth full of teeth.
The ones in the back.
All these are delayed.
Marcus smiles so wide, you see the hinge in the back.
Come on now. I saw all his fillings.
I thought he was a pence dispenser.
Not a pence dispenser.
If you know what that is, that means you're old, for real.
Give me 1 second.
Oh, you got what is? I said you was old, Marcus.
What is the pest? What is a pest dispenser? I don't know that.
You know what the hell it is.
The head and the little candies come out.
No,
I don't know exactly what they is. He used to make them. I don't know why he's acting like
you. Well, you remember
my generation never heard of that.
You remember 8-tracks, Al?
He remember life before the Pence dispenser.
That's dude, I remember life before 8-tracks. What are you talking about, 8-tracks?
Oh, my God.
I remember when there was no 8-tracks.
Damn, I remember when there wasn't no such thing as record players.
Yeah. He had to wind it up. Yeah.
Well, we're going to go ahead and get started because I'm not sure. I'm not seeing us on Facebook Live, but it's still trying to go in. So we're going to go ahead and get started. Good morning, everyone. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, guys.
Put the cup. Oh, here we go. There we go.
It's good to see all of you here. Hold up your cups. And let's say, hold up your oatmeal, Alyssa.
get your cup of oats.
Oh, she got the coffee cup.
Oh, now she got coffee.
I do. I got them both. Here we go.
Double fisted.
She's going to eat and drink at the same time. It's good to have you guys joining me here and joining the world on Facebook Live. This is our second addition to this series of Coffee and Conversation with Marcus Anthony, and it's good to have you here. We got some super entertainment for you again today. I'm gonna love this show. It's gonna be crazy. I'm gonna have to take a tranquilizer. I don't know why I'm drinking so much coffee, but I'm gonna have to take something to bring me down after this show today. Couple things. I'm loving that people are doing so much to come together in this time of distress, ladies and gentlemen. The families are coming together, spending more time with each other because they have to. And what's that?
Getting on each other's nerves.
No, it's not people are getting on each other's nerves. They love each other.
I'm in marriage counseling.
But can you imagine what it would have been like just a few years earlier without all its technology? You see the TikToks and people. Percy's working on a TikTok right now. I saw your dad do a little TikTok dance out there working, but we're going to get to that in just a little bit. I'm going to start the show with a song. Oh, did you see the thing with the truck driver, the garbage truck driver? He did something where some kids were doing a TikTok and he joined in. They were graduating. And he stopped and wished them, gave them encouragement from a sanitation truck. And I thought that was great. And then the mail lady, I saw this morning.
I saw that, yeah.
That was so cute. She's like, hello.
I think we lost that. Perfect thing. I'm going to start off with a song. So let me get into that in just a second. But yeah, it was just fun to see. This is song. I'm just throwing this out. I've always loved this song. It's Elton John tune. And I'm throwing it out to all my Facebook family, friends, Cruise fam, and the people in this room. Are you ready?
Woo!
Let's go.
We're ready.
I'm not ready. Oh, Lord.
The image keeps freezing and unfreezing from time to time. I don't know if you noticed.
Yeah. Who's freezing?
Yeah, Mark, Al, you have to start typing those in the chats.
What?
just telling all the business. Where is your grandkids so we can get somebody to help you over there?
It's a little bit funny, this feeling inside. It's not one of those you can easily hide. Don't have much money, but if I did, I'd buy a big ship where we all could live. Big old ship. If I was going to die. But then again, for me, it's the shepherds and the traveling shepherds. No, it's not what we love, but it's the best I can do. My gift is my song, yeah. This one's for me. And you can tell everybody this is your song. It may be quite simple, but all that's done. I hope you don't mind, but I hope you don't mind that I put down in words. How wonderful. Song. Ladies and gentlemen, on our show today, we have the great Al Romero, we have Azeem, we have Percy Cruz II, Alyssa, and we also have, Alyssa's going to be doing a couple songs for us a little bit later on. We also have Ben Nismer.
Hey,
there you are. Oh. It's good to see you. You got something on your shirt.
Oh, but, yeah, that's a surprise for later.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm glad you pointed that out. That's going to be a surprise for later.
Excellent, excellent. Well, Al, we're going to start with Al. Al Romero, what's going on?
How are you, buddy? Thank you for having me.
It's good to see you here.
Thank you.
How have you been holding up, my friend?
Well, like everybody else, man, try to make it, try to see how you live under this, science fiction bad movie that we're all living in, you know?
We're all living in it. I've been thinking about it over and over again at night during my sleep and staying up during the day just to make it a beautiful day. We're all in this together. Now, you also have written a book. You have your own podcast. Tell us something about that.
Well, yeah, I did write a book called Revolution. It's a novel. My family was very much involved with Fidel Castro, then against him. And then my uncle started working with the CIA while he was still in Castro's armed forces. So I wrote a novel. I novelized it. You know, like The Godfather is different mafia story, mafia family put together to tell the story of The Godfather. I use the same formula. So that's my book. It's still good. Yeah. I'm going to write another one. How I suffer working with Percy Cruz on Carnival Cruise Line. that's my second title. I'm working on that. Yeah.
Well, we've all.
It's going to be a very, very long book. So it's going to take me a long time. Yeah.
Well, you wanted to move in with Percy, I understand.
Because what happened is that I'm running out of money. I have to move in for somebody. So Percy was very nice to say, Al, come over. You're welcome.
Al is doing very well.
I don't have Percy money, okay? Nobody has Percy money.
I'm in Al's house. I'm like, damn.
So you also have your own comedy show that you're doing. Have you set up anything for after this is over, when Florida or Miami opens up? Because Miami's still on lockdown.
Yeah, I know, man. Listen, Asim and I were talking about it before the show started.
Oh my goodness.
That we are, we have been hit worse than anybody, the entertainment business, live entertainment. You know, by definition, we need a crowd to entertain, and crowds are the last thing anybody wants. So we've been affected more than anybody.
Yes, that is true. You guys do need somebody to, I call Azeem and I call Percy a lot so that they can practice. They always practice on me, so. I don't know why they insist on talking about this. Just hound me. That's okay.
First of all, Marcus, I just want to send you my condolences for your dad that passed away, Little Richard.
Tutti Frutti.
Tutti Frutti. Yes, he will be missed.
Don't you think that Pat Boone's version of Tutti Frutti was better? It's nothing like a white guy going Tutti Frutti, oh Rudy, with no rhythm whatsoever.
It was a lot of those songs like that back in the day.
Oh man!
But what's the name of your book, Al?
It's called Revolution. That's it. One word. Yeah. Now, the best way to get it is Amazon. Put Revolution by Al Romero. It comes right up. You can buy it anywhere, too. Any bookstore. You have to order it, though. It's not going to be on the shelf. Although it was at the airport. I had the airport bookstore had it.
It was at the airport?
Yeah. In the bookstore. Miami Airport.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Excellent. Did anybody pass by and see that, Azeem, his book?
I'm just trying to figure out how the hell you going to tell me I can buy it anywhere, but it ain't going to be on the shelf.
Well, I've seen this. You order it.
You can order online. Don't tell nobody that it ain't at the bookstore, Al. It could be.
You can go to the bookstore, and if you're buying another book, this is the guy talking right here.
Bookstore, what's that? That's so 20.
Just said, bookstore is closed. Ain't gonna be no more Barnes and Noble. Quarantine over.
Well, they're gonna open before we start working.
Just order it online for other people that think he's crazy. Just order his His book is good. I had
Amazon.
It was in print, and it's real good.
Thank you, buddy.
Al, have you been able to get out to the beach or to the park? They opened up a park, babe.
Actually, I was amazed. My daughter moved to Sarasota, so we went to see her for Mother's Day. And we went to Siesta Key. The west coast of Florida is open a lot more than the east coast. And you should see the people walking all over Siesta Key. Restaurants open, bars open. It was like you never knew that there wasn't a virus going on.
Right. Up north, northern Florida, yeah, northern Florida and northwest Florida, they've opened up, and I guess are now they doing social distancing or?
Well, let me tell you, when you're walking down the street and you're passing people 6 inches away from you, that's no social distancing, you know.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
And I'm telling you, it was packed. It was packed. People walking down the street, it was packed.
Did you have your mask on?
Yes, I did. Yeah. Although nobody else did. On the West Coast, nobody wore a mask. I don't know. It's so weird how everybody approaches this differently, you know?
Well, they don't drink Corona up there. I saw a post that was a lady did.
Yeah, right. You saw that one, right?
Yeah, I saw it. It was insane.
It was Corona drinking.
Yeah. They're drinking it out of a can, not here in Miami.
Right.
Well, it's good to have you here with us. And I hope that anytime that you want to jump in and say something to Azeem. Azeem is another comedian and a good friend that I've been working with. Hey, Azeem, what's going on, my friend?
What's up, good brother?
How's everything?
Boy, look here, I am doing good. I'm up for your show.
I'm loving the beard.
Hey, man, appreciate it. Love yours, too, as well. You got all that salt and a slice of pepper. Okay. Yeah. I thought you was getting ready to audition for a new Pirates of the Caribbean. Where they finally gonna have.
I hope they have an audition. I'll do it.
Black Jack Sparrow.
Black Jack Sparrow.
Yeah, Johnny Depp too weak to do
it. No, really, you look like Levi Stubbs from the Four Tops, but go ahead.
Sugar Pie, Honey Bunch. Go ahead, I see.
Yeah, but I'm good, man. I'm doing good, man. Just glad to be out here with y'all and my amazing five counterparts out here doing their thing. We just got to witness somebody eating grits out of a cup and lying and calling them oatmeal. But you know, and that's how God reveals it. So, you know, I'm good, but I'm a little pissed off. I heard Al talking about that y'all in Florida now starting to let people go outside. See, you know, this is how people get slapped in the mouth. I don't appreciate it. Is too early to be going off quarantine. It is too early for that. See, this is what my grandmama would have called pneumonia weather. You know, when you go right, soon as they said go outside, here's the stupid part. Because somebody tell you can go outside, if you still know it's danger out there, quarantine yourself. I'm on a self-quarantine.
You ain't got and we're, time. Yeah, we're very happy for it.
Back up, I see your nostrils. Listen, and that left one is a little thick, so you need to ask your wife for a bobby pin or something. Look, but I'm saying, man, you don't go outside in this, man. Like, you know, when it feel warm and it's January and it feel like 75 degrees, you think, oh, I'm gonna go out in t-shirt. Your mama say, where you going? I'm going outside. You better go get a jacket. That's pneumonia weather. That's what's going on out there right now.
Well, if you want to bitch slap some people, go to Sarasota.
Well, you went over there.
Yes, I did.
So I'm on my way. The thing is,
I'm your first victim.
First victim, you got to get it. Because I'm telling you right now, man, but I've been on quarantine so long, man, I'm doing things differently now, Marcus. I got dressed up the other day, and my wife was like, where are you going? I said, what you mean? Just getting dressed up. She's talking about where are you going? I said, I'm getting ready to go take the trash out. I had on a full suit and my dress shoes, my hard bottoms. Just take the trash out.
That is country right there.
Turn some music on and hope some other people would come and take their trash out so we could have a trash block party because there's enough distance in there. You know what I'm saying? You need that space. Now, the other thing is, I don't understand everybody talking about social distancing. Social distancing for Al, you know, he married, you know, that he definitely 6 feet apart from his spouse.
So further.
And you know, that's how you end up. You ain't have to yawn right in the middle of my. That was real messed up.
She was burping. She was burping some grits.
That was probably from all those dang on oatmeal. Grits. So she went right to her.
I know, time to go to sleep.
That oatmeal setting in is what it is.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you got the itis.
So I mean, I'm just trying to make it, man. I've been getting involved in arts and crafts. You know, masks wasn't available at the store, so you know, they said.
Did you make the mask that you have on?
Yeah, this one right here. This one. Now, this one here is a very special one. It's
I'm glad you coughed after you put it on.
Yeah, I had to because this is a bra. So it still got a little bit of breast dust under it.
Yeah. Breast dust.
Yeah, because it get caught in that underwire. So,
oh God.
Now, I understand why women be talking about it now. You know, that underwire, it'll catch up on you and choke you.
That bra can fit over your whole head.
Yeah, well, you know, I'm thankful. The thing is, so, you know, because some women got a breast so small, it don't even fit over a nostril.
The eye patch.
You hear me? Because I'm like, I can't do nothing with that. Here's the point I'm making. You know, so I got creative with that, and I thank God for that. It's got several barriers in there. But I was at Lowe's the other day, and I came across somebody who breath. They Brett. You have to say Brett, because if you get the out, the Brett that they had was so bad. The dude had a mask on and I smelt it through that.
You know what? It's a lot of people finding out they got bad breath. Now.
Boy, look here. The breath, I mean, because as soon as you put it on, it's an instant reveal.
You ever had some friends?
He was looking like, man, I got to take this mask back. I said, "What? Why you say that? Because every time I put it on, it smells like somebody, it's been used. I said, that's your breath. That's you. But everyone in the pack that's your Brett. That's your Brett.
It's a very teachable moment, isn't it?
Yeah, and people be talking in your face like as if, you know, like they don't even know you smell that.
Can I ask a question?
Go ahead, Percy.
How come people with bad breath always use H words?
That's what I'm saying. Right here.
Don't like, huff me.
I'm telling you, huff at me one more time. I'm going to hit the word in your mouth with Altoids.
There's some friends that
they're around, man.
You know,
around. What's up, Marcus?
People that's got bad breath, but I ain't never said nothing to them about it.
No, I talk.
I'm glad I'm here.
You got to tell them that they breath funky, man. Because you ever work with somebody? I used to work at this job, this dude named James. And James had that.
Oh, you just going to say the name?
Yeah. I deal with mine. If you got bad breath, I'm going to straight tell you. Back up. Now, James had that breath, but now wasn't nobody else going to tell him. And he used to always want to talk to the girls at the little water cooler. And they would just be trying to hold it, you know, like this, like as if he was anticipating. And when he would leave, the tears would flow. Now, I told him, I said, I'm going to tell James his breath stink, but you got to do it in a cool way. So one day he was like, hey, Zim. And I was like, James, you smell that? He said, no. I said, right there. Seemed like every time you open your mouth, that's when the funky come out. He said, let's be quiet. Let's see if we smell it now. Nope. He said, show them. See, there it go again. I think we need to spray some Febreze in the back of your throat. Put it in the breeze.
They got a stomach problem. In the breeze. You know, a lot of people found it out, man, why people been hanging up the phone on.
Well,
it'll cut your broadband out. Some people breath so bad.
Now you're doing a lot of work outside around your house. You said your wife she put you out to do the work.
Yeah, she did. She put me outside. We now have some beautiful flowers in the back that I had to dig some holes for through rock, and I was like
through rock.
I don't even fool with rocks. I stopped selling those at 17, and I definitely didn't want to dig any up. So there's a few slow people.
I'm with you, brother. But
I know it's a few people from Sacramento that act as if they don't know.
Hey, listen.
But nonetheless, yes, we have some beautiful flowers out there. And then
I know Cuba know what time it is.
I
have no idea what you guys are talking about.
And I now have a bad sciatic nerve. So,
by the way, I just realized I'm the token Cuban on this show. Is that right? Hey. I just realized that. Wait a minute.
The token, you're free.
Ironically, I might be the token on this show. So.
Well, you're never the token because you all make the rules, Ben. So,
I mean, you know.
You're the supervisor. That's what you are. White people can never play the token role because you all make the rules. You wrote the book. It's called the Constitution. So we got to work. We get amendments. We get amendments. Makes you the supervisor.
Well, that's how I got booked on this show.
No, because we had to have one of you present.
Oh, and I think he has his name. Your name on his little thing, like Mr. Green Jeans,
right?
Man, you old. Hey, Al, somebody just ordered your book. Thanks to Debbie Camp Prothero, she just bought your book. So, you know, I'm glad I told her not to drive to Barnes and Noble to pick it up. So it'll be there before they could get it. So
I'm going to change the name of my next book to.
You might want to say thank you, Debbie Prothero. Yeah. For purpose in the book, I just gave you some information. I'm using
my thank you, Debbie, very much.
Don't interrupt me while I'm talking.
Changing the name of my next book, though.
Now, one thing about Azeem, he is a good salesperson. So, Al,
buy this or I'll kick your ass.
I'm getting 30% off that book sale.
30%.
It's the only book that's been sold this month.
Well, it's good. It's good.
Okay,
talking.
You only get one more cough, Alyssa.
Look,
you must be on that 5G.
I'm trying to tell you,
you ain't ready for outside.
The computer.
Marcus, what were you saying?
We got to back up away from Alyssa.
Turn her screen off.
I'm trying to tell you.
Well, listen. Before we go any further, I want to remind everyone that is joining us on the show that this is a GoFundMe fundraiser. You guys can go to my GoFundMe page, Coffee and Conversation. And if you're enjoying the show, if you want to give a little something for these people, feel free to do so. Every little bit helps. Like I said in the first show, we don't get the, we have not yet gotten any government support, whether it be somebody might have got food stamps because I saw them with the.
Don't put my business in the street like that. Somebody might have got stamps and then it came right to my.
Somebody.
But we hope that.
And it was a wig voucher.
It was a voucher. They stopped you and gave you a voucher. But just. Dig in just a little bit if you're enjoying it. Make us a donation and so that it can be shared amongst the people that are on the show today. Ben.
Hey, how's it going?
Ben Nimsa.
That's me.
Good to see you.
It's good to see you too, man. Last time I saw you, we were literally on the other side of the world.
We really were.
We were in Tahiti, right?
Yes.
Yeah, we were in Tahiti and I remember first time I went to Tahiti, by the way, I went, I'm going to Tahiti. And they put me in the worst hotel I've ever stayed in my entire life. I was afraid to leave. And then 6 months later, I go to Tahiti with you. And Marcus is such a big deal with Carnival that everybody he was traveling with, they put in the Intercontinental Hotel. Not even an overnight trip, just a day trip until we could get to the airport with like 5-star luxury steak dinners, like villas. So I'm going to tell you, if anyone can ever travel with Marcus, he's hooked up.
It was a nice hotel, and they wanted to take care of all of us. It wasn't.
I piggybacked on you for sure.
It was a great hotel. We had the rooms, and we had all kinds of great food. I remember all the people that were with us, and we went out and stayed by the pool because our flights weren't until what, midnight?
Yeah, it was something like that. Yeah,
but we had to get off the ship, so. They put us in a nice place. Now you're in New York, am I correct?
Yeah, New York City, Manhattan.
Wow.
Yeah.
He got that Percy money too.
Wow. Not anymore.
Percy was living in Jersey.
Where in Jersey?
I was in West Orange.
Oh, that's not too far.
Yeah, I was in West Orange.
So you're in Manhattan. So you're in the midst of all of this. You're like in ground zero.
Yeah, well, it's pretty bad here. Nobody's really going outside unless you need essentials, food, supplies. We walk our dog 3 times a day, and that's pretty much it. That's the only time we go outside.
Now, I see that you're stocked up pretty well with the alcohol.
Oh, yeah, we got some.
Is that what's in your cup?
No, this is just some espresso. I've been making some of my own coffee. We got a French press, cooking all my meals.
Oh, fancy.
Taking advantage of the time home.
So you're ordering out a lot. You're ordering your food from the grocery and...
We're cooking a lot. We're doing like Amazon delivery, and they'll deliver all of our groceries. And I really enjoy cooking. I just never have the time. So now I have all the time in the world. Yeah, I cook all my meals. Sure.
Now, you said you and your wife are doing a show together, and have you been able to formulate new material?
One of the things that I was talking to somebody about is, there's two ways you can go into this mindset. You can go in and say, oh, this is terrible. I don't have work. And what am I going to do? Or you can, use the time and come out of this with something really solid. So we were at the point where I was working for Carnival, Disney, Norwegian, Azamara, a bunch of different cruise lines, the Staten Island Ferry, anywhere that would have me.
Okay.
but recently my wife and I started doing our 2-person show on headlining on Norwegian Cruise Line.
Okay.
A 2-magician show. So she's also a magician as well. And not one of those like boxy illusion type shows, but comedy, interactive magic. And now we're kind of, I guess the name of the game is adapting. So we've transformed our living room into a rehearsal space. And we also started doing Zoom shows. So, it's not cruise ship money, but we have a little girl we teach Zoom magic lessons to once a week. And last night I performed for a family of 3 people, a mom, a dad, and a son. And they had money and they just wanted to have a nice 45-minute bonding experience. And we did interactive magic through the screen.
Okay.
The day before we had a group of 30 people all chiming in for somebody's 25th birthday party. And then the day before that, we had a 7-year-old birthday party, and my wife and I did excerpts from our stage show in our living room for a whole bunch of 7-year-olds.
Who books that?
Who books that? I'll get you booked. Nobody wants to pay good money, but I think that's going to change hopefully. I'm optimistic. We'll see. Maybe it won't change.
To be optimistic. We're entertainers and we are optimistic. We just have that optimistic dream,
Yeah.
And so that's a good thing. Now, I'm very curious as to what that envelope is.
So let's talk. So I'm glad you pointed this out at the beginning when we started talking. And I'm glad you pointed out at the very beginning of the broadcast, because I made a point of like keeping my chest up here. So that this envelope, can you see if I bring it up close? It's an envelope, and I safety pinned it to my, I don't know if you saw me safety pinning it and clipping it on earlier, but I safety pinned it to my shirt, and I made some predictions because I went to bed last night, and I had these crazy ideas of what I thought was going to happen during our session here, and I wrote it down. I sealed it. This is actually an old envelope from my wedding a long time ago, but I had one left. And anyway, I'll tell you about that in a second. But I'm looking down at our chat, and I see we have 15 people watching. Sorry, 1,500. I lost the zeros. So it's thousands and thousands of people watching us on Facebook. And I know that a lot of people have been watching TV, you know, binging on all kinds of TV shows. And Tiger King is like the one everybody's watching.
Right.
But there's a lot of shows that other people have been binge watching. So I want to get just one suggestion from the audience in the comments, somebody who's watching, of a TV show that you've really been binging on. So go ahead. If you're watching this stream now, in the comments, type something that you've kind of been binge watching on either Netflix or Hulu. I'll give you guys like 10 seconds. If nobody comments, I'm going to open it up to the rest of the panel here. All right, nobody's typing in the comments. So how about one of you guys?
Go ahead, guys.
Who's been watching the show they want to chime in on?
Ozark.
Murder Heist.
I've been watching. We got to go with the first thing. Who said that?
Ozark.
Oh, I can't see your face. Who said that?
That's Al.
That was Al.
Oh, Al said that. Al. Okay, Al said Ozark. You know, it's so funny. I knew you were going to say Ozark, and I knew nobody was going to chime in time, so I knew you were going to say Ozark. But that's fine. I'll show you later. Now, in addition to, I told you, I've been cooking a lot, right? Is there anybody else who's been, like, cooking or really enjoyed eating a food? Oh, yes. Like, yeah?
Yes, it right. is.
How about Azeem?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, what food have you been really?
Man, I've been making oyster mushrooms.
Oyster mushrooms.
Yeah, man, it tastes just like chicken, man.
I'm glad you've been trying to get everything taste like chicken.
I don't, you know, I saw oyster mushrooms on a menu recently, and I didn't order it because I thought it was oysters, but I actually know about them now.
Yeah, man,
they do like what they call it, like chicken of the forest or something.
Oh, is that what they call it? But it's delicious.
Yeah.
Don't look like
and,
that.
Marcus, I want you to pick a card. And I brought with me a deck of cards. And obviously you can see every single card in the entire deck is different.
Uh-huh.
And I'm going to come nice and close. Can you see here that every single card is different as I go like this with my thumb?
Yes.
Yeah? All right. Anytime you like, you just say the word stop.
Stop.
Okay, and not the one I can see. Let's take the one here. I'm going to turn my head. Do you see that card right there?
Yes.
Okay, I see it too, but that's fine. I do want to point out that this has never left your site, and I'm going to unpin it from my shirt without taking it out of the frame. So let's... There we go.
Yes, it's some work. You got that really pinned up there well.
Now, inside the envelope, can you see that prediction?
No. No, we can't. Oh, there.
Yeah, there, right? I'm going to keep this in frame. I'm not going to let it leave frame once. And the funniest thing is the first thing in the prediction, it says...
Turn it upside. It's upside down.
Sorry. Now, I did write this last night, so I didn't know how to spell your name, Azeem, but in my dream, I knew it was Azeem. And I wrote,
get out of here, dude.
Azeem wrote oyster mushrooms. Yeah. Because last night, when Marcus told me you were on the show, he didn't tell me how to spell your name.
So I don't know if you're missing a part of your chest, but your wife wrote through your back.
And then I wrote this one over here.
Mushrooms on there.
Says
it's upside down.
Al watched Ozark. Oh,
wow. Come on.
Wow.
Wow.
And the craziest thing is, Marcus, I knew what you were gonna say.
Oh my god.
I knew Marcus was gonna choose a four.
Amazing.
Wow. Yeah,
wow.
Amazing.
That's awesome. Good job.
That is amazing. How did you do that?
I'm never
can't tell you.
That is amazing.
That's called
me. That's why he's the supervisor.
That's why he's the supervisor. I take back everything I said about you, Ben. We're great friends, and we have been for years.
There we are. All right, I'll take it.
Wow. I wish, you know, it would have been so amazing because we did not have any type of conversation.
No.
At all.
No, I've never met him in my life. So
you seem pretty happy about that, Al.
Well, not real happy, but content. Content is the word.
Yeah. I don't know if we've met in person, but we've like passed each other on shift.
I'm sure we have.
Getting on, I've been getting off. I've read your name in the program as the comedian. Oh yeah, that comedian was great. Who was it? Al. Yeah, he got off last night. So
wow. It's amazing. That was beautiful. That was totally amazing. I'm blown
away. Oh, thanks. I'm glad you like that.
And this is for the first time Zim is quiet. I can't believe it.
Because you told me to be quiet during people's spots. The one that's actually doing it. Everybody chimed in on my time, but I said.
I'm sorry. My bad. You can chime in.
Don't worry about it. You up next.
I know. There's a person watching the game in the background. You see that?
Well, Ben, thank you very much for joining us here. I'm sure a lot of people are going to make a great deal of donations based on all you guys.
No. See, the point is make your donations willingly because if you don't, Ben is going to delete all the money from your account. And it's
right.
If that boy knew I was going to say oyster mushrooms,
come on.
You already know your debit card now. Wow.
And make your donations to Al Romero, R-O-M-E-R-O.
Alyssa.
Yes. Hi. Oh, good. I'm sleepy.
You're out there in California.
Yes, I am.
Where in California are you?
I'm in Northern California, Sacramento, city of trees.
Mm-hmm. Excellent. Is the weather beautiful out there? You guys are cooperating with the separation?
Somewhat. Apparently, you know, people are still kind of wilding out in the streets. But for the most part, people are following directions. The weather's been really good, except for yesterday and today. It's like kind of overcast. But overall, you see people like jogging, riding their bikes. Like, yeah, like Al said, it's almost like you don't even know there's like a pandemic going on. People are just like doing their own thing. So.
Out everywhere. Now.
Yeah, but I hear on the West Coast, you know, it's getting better like versus the East Coast.
Right.
That's what I've heard. Like no new cases and stuff like that. So.
Now you and I worked together once, along with one last week and a couple of the other people that were on last week. And we had a great time with that. Being on there, Miles was on there. Azeem, you okay with your, he's got his mask, he's falling asleep. What happened?
Don't fall asleep now.
Oh no, I was just getting ready for my yawn.
Okay. And you did a fantastic show. We had a great time with that. And then we all just hung out together like we always do on the ships and it was fun. It was a delight to hang out with you and meet you. Now, you sing.
I do.
So we'd like to hear a couple of somethings.
Oh, you would?
Would you guys like to hear something from Alyssa?
Definitely.
Let's make it happen.
Wow, this is all so unexpected. I don't know, but okay. I guess I will. Okay, so you said you want about two songs. I got two songs for you.
Okay.
Let's start it off with a little Stevie. Kind of get some blood flowing in here, something up tempo, okay? So I know you guys know this song and I know we're all on Zoom, but I want you to like sing along and clap your hands and yeah, enjoy it, all right? Here we go. All right. Tell me, let me know if you can hear it. Hey, come on, y'all. Can you hear it?
Turn up your volume a little bit. Turn up your volume.
I think that's as loud as it goes. Come on. Like a fool, I went and stayed too long. Now I'm wondering if your love's still strong. Ooh, baby. Here I am. Signed, sealed, delivered. I'm yours. Come on, y'all. Woo! Then that time I went and said goodbye. Now I'm back and not ashamed to cry. Ooh, baby, Here I am, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Woo! Here I am, baby. Signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Hey, come on. Here I am, baby. Signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Hey, woo! I've done a lot of foolish things that I really didn't mean. I'll be here for you, baby. Woo! Seen a lot of things in this old world. When I touched them, they did nothing, girl. Ooh, baby. Here I am, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Hey, yeah. Ooh, wee, baby, set my soul on fire. That's why I know you're my only desire. Ooh, baby, here I am, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Hey, sing it. Here I am, baby. A sign, seal, deliver, I'm yours. Hey, yeah. Said, here I am, baby. Sign, seal, deliver, I'm yours. Yeah. I did a lot of foolish things that I really didn't mean. I'll be here for you, baby. Hey, yeah. Here I am, baby. Sign, seal, deliver, I'm yours. Yeah, yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
That was beautiful. Beautiful.
Oh, you're so sweet. Thank you.
Alyssa, how long have you been singing? When did you start singing?
Like, from the beginning, like, maybe since I was about... I've been writing songs since I was about 10 or 11, and I started like performing when I was really young as well.
So you write your own songs as well?
I do write my own songs, and I have actually, I forgot to tell you this, but yeah, I have a new EP that just came out about 3 weeks ago. It's like a mini album. It's okay. 6 songs, and it's all original music, and you guys can all find that on all streaming platforms. And on my website.
All right. And what do you have a website? What's your website?
My website is alyssaharrismusic.com.
Excellent. Excellent. Yay. I'm sure people will go over. Keep track of that, Azeem, please. People will. Anybody else buy any of Al's books? Keep us posted.
Yeah. And those can be also ordered at Barnes and Noble. But it would be better. It's not on the shelf, but you can just order it there as well.
Well, if you're there already.
Well, you know what? Alyssa, how long have you been working with the cruise lines?
So I started working with Carnival in 2013 as a show band singer and then a production singer. And then I worked as... kind of switched companies and then came back and finally have been doing guest entertainer for the past 2 years. So it's okay. Been like, yeah, long time, 7 years now.
I'm sorry, Marcus.
Sorry.
I've never met you on the show.
You know, Percy, I think I met you like very briefly on an embark day, like in the MSA office. You were leaving.
Yeah.
Coming on. I want to say it was the Legend. I think I could be wrong, but.
Baltimore.
Was that in Baltimore?
It was out of Baltimore, yeah.
Oh, you got a good memory. I thought it was, the Pride?
The Pride.
Yeah. The Pride is in Baltimore, yeah.
Cool. We went across paths too, Alyssa. Where were you during Hurricane Harvey? Were you on a ship?
Ooh, that's the one that was in Houston, right?
Yeah.
When was that?
Which natural disaster pandemic?
I know. Well, remember there was kind of that hurricane in September. I was on the Aleutian and I got stuck. Were you on that with me? I can't remember.
No, I wasn't on that one. No, I thought you might have been, we might have just briefly passed. I was on a ship in New Orleans that just went in and out of.
Oh, okay. No, I haven't done any New Orleans ships yet.
Oh, okay. All right. Never mind.
Yeah.
Well, we want to know would you do another song for us right now?
Yeah.
Absolutely. And since, you know, we haven't been on ships and we haven't been able to do our shows, I thought I would do a song from my show just because I miss it so much, you know?
Cool.
And Marcus has been the only one that's actually seen my show. So everyone, this will be new to everyone else, okay?
I think there was a little bit of a tude with that, that nobody else saw.
No, it's okay. No, it's okay.
Did you catch that, Percy?
I caught on.
This ain't nobody else seen it.
You know what I mean? And we ain't all eating oatmeal.
I mean, right. Some of us can't afford
it. Basically said, if we don't like it, it's Marcus's fault because he's the only one who.
It's always Marcus's fault.
It's gonna be terrific. It's gonna be terrific.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's a slow song, so you know, get your drink and your relax, sit back and relax.
I need my tissue.
Maybe. Yeah, it might get emotional. You might get emotional.
Yes, you be. Okay.
Get a little perklip.
All right, I'm going to mute my microphone.
All right.
There you go.
Oh, wait, hold on. I'm pulling a Marcus here. Hold on. Wait a minute. Let me get my music on.
At least everybody know what pulling a Marcus is.
I know, I'm a mess. Okay.
It's going to become a standard in the industry, pulling a Marcus.
Yeah, I'm getting ready to take her a picture off.
Okay, I'm going to have you close to the... Okay, hold on. Okay, here we go. If I were your woman,
on with it now.
And you were my man. You have no other woman. You'd be weak as a lamb if you had the strength to walk out my door. My love would overrule my sense, and I'd call you back for more if I were your woman. If I were your woman, and you were my man. Yeah. She tears you down, darling. Says you're nothing at all. But I pick you up, darling, when she makes you fall. Cause you're like a diamond, but she treats you like glass. And you beg her to love you. With me, you don't ask if I were your woman.
Sing the songs. Will you sing?
If I were your woman, if I were your woman, here's what I do. I never, ever, no, stop loving you. Yeah. Life is so crazy and love is unkind, but because she was first, darling, will she hang on your mind? You're a part of me, but you don't even know it. I'm what you need, but I'm too afraid to show it. If I were your woman, if I were your woman, if I were your woman, here's what I'd do. I never stop loving you.
All right, now she killed that.
Did she do it?
Oh, thank you.
Come on, did she now. Do it? Did she do it?
Come on now. Gladys can't even sing it no more. It's cut off.
That was beautiful.
Yeah. But by the way, Percy, she was not singing the song just to you.
Because
you were acting like it was like something between the two, just for you. No, it was for all of us. It was for all of us, Percy.
I know, but
these songs, those type of songs like that, man, and Aretha Franklin and the Temptations, and you know, and all these songs back in the day, man, take me back to 4236 Oakwood, St. Louis, Missouri, 63121. You understand
Come
me?
Come on, man.
Come on. You know what I'm saying? Come all on. This back in the day, because our house was like a club back in the day. You know, every weekend, everybody came to our house, man. We had the cold sound system with the microphone. We had a spotlight, man. It was 8-track back in the day. We had the buffet bar with the wings, the chicken wings. And I'm not talking about the little chicken wings they had a day. I'm talking about the chicken wings that look like a big four to come back across the top. But I'm talking about, baby, potato salad, everything, man. All of this back in the day, all the liquor. We had everything the liquor store had on the bar. We had on the bar down to the rack of pork skins with hot sauce, because black people got to have hot sauce with a pork skin. You understand me? This was all before my mom and them got saved. But go ahead on, girl, sing the song.
Everybody give a listen.
But how do you feel about it? How do you feel about it, Percy? Don't hold back. How do you really
feel?
Tell
us how you really feel.
Percy lost that intro.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you didn't know, Alyssa, thank you. Alyssa Harris, we're going to be looking out for your works. Continuing to look for you on the
show.
That
was beautiful.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Very good.
Percy Cruz, ladies and gentlemen, that's who was speaking. That's my oldest brother, ladies and gentlemen.
How many times? First of all,
you're here in Miami too, so.
I am. You know, Marcus is the oldest. Marcus looked good, only he 87. He looks
I'm the ancient one here.
Yeah,
I'm always the ancient one.
You know, but it's good to have you here joining. We can't, you know, we talk on the phone all the time, just like Azeem and I. We all talk together a lot. And we did Azeem's show.
Yes, Azeem, we did. Also has a and had a wonderful time.
I'm glad you brought up my show, Marcus. Thank you. At the end of this one.
Go ahead, Azeem. Tell us about your show.
Don't even worry about it. Don't even worry about it.
Well, I want to talk about mine.
I don't want to cut into Percy time. Go on, Percy.
Go ahead, dog. What do you think? We had a wonderful time. Not a wonderful time.
It was just a little small thing I do on Saturdays. It's nothing. No.
It's a great show, and we had a great time on it. And Consuelo was on it the week before, 2 weeks before I was on your show.
Yeah.
Tell them what the name of your show is. We'll get back to it.
No, it's all good. It's just Encore Supper Club. It's the
Encore Supper Club.
It's a virtual club where we have a variety of wonderful acts as comedians and singers. And now magicians who know I eat oyster mushrooms.
Well, I'm in. If you'll have me, I'm there.
Oh, they gotta have you, man. We gotta have you opening up, man. That's how we gotta do it. So, yeah, you can catch it on Saturdays, but you have to catch me at azeemcomedy.com. Or you can follow me at Azeem Comedy on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter. I'm not doing TikTok.
We got to get you to do TikTok. TikTok. The whole family.
And mine is called Stand Up Guy Radio. You can go.
We had already talked about your show already.
No, we did not. We did not.
We already talked about your show from the beginning.
No. Yeah, but we were not on the air.
We were on the air.
No, we're not.
Yes, we were.
Well, listen.
Even when he is live.
Yeah, listen. We need to be. We need to talk about it a lot.
You can also order your own Al Romero.
What was that?
But you can go to the bookstore to purchase Al Romero.
I would drive. Get in your car and drive to the bookstore
and get it online.
Don't use your computer. Don't use your computer. Get in your car. Go to the store and order it there.
Percy,
yes, sir.
You have been living it up with the family. I understand that you've been building, doing construction. With your mom.
You know, my wife is Puerto Rican, so this is my first time being in a Latin family. I didn't know what it was like. It's similar a little bit to being in a black family, because Puerto Ricans ain't nothing but light-skinned black people. Anyway, like I was saying, right? But they work every day. Oh my God, they work every day. We've been doing stuff out in the backyard. They have me cracking rocks like I was Nelson Mandela on Robben Island. But I'm telling you, but you know, we got it all done, man. We put up like what four concrete walls. We put up four concrete walls for a gate.
Wow.
We painted everything. We put, it took me and Theo. Theo means uncle. In or Theo, T-I-O. Theo means uncle in Spanish. It took us 4 days to put up two ceiling fans. Do you understand me? Because Theo was running the electricity, and I wasn't about to put my hand in no kind of electricity. He like me, I'm like, well, can we just turn off the power, right? And my stepson like, no, we got the server on. If the server go off, we gonna lose money. I said, well, I'd rather lose money than a light. But he's like, no, damn the light. This, we got to have the money. So I'm like, okay, I'm not putting my hand in no wire. So Theo did it. You understand me? Now, he did get shocked a couple times. I did have a piece of plastic in my hand or wood to knock him off the electricity if it got too bad. Now, I was going to bust his head to the white meat, but he would have lived. You understand me? So we put up these fans, man. Like I said, it took us about 3 or 4 days just to run the electricity right. We had to watch, you know, a video, because I'm like, first of all, Theo, you know, this, they got wires on this, and my thing just went out. It's got Manly F. I don't know who the hell. Manly F. What are you doing, Marcus, with the hose? You're the one. What the hell is going on, Marcus? That's all I'm trying to say. You didn't do that with none of the other people. But when we come on, you got to put Manly F up on the damn screen. Now, can you put my face on the screen?
That's because Mark.
Thank you very much.
Mark is just going through a quarantine struggle over there. That's one of his extra special guests. That's on at 12:05.
Anyway, we got the fans up. We did a lot of painting. Mommy is a beast. Mommy mixing concrete. Mommy's spreading the concrete out and everything, man. I'm telling you, mommy on it. Now, my father-in-law loves to cook. Been cooking every day. You understand me? When they leave, I don't know what the hell I'm gonna do, because my wife told me I'm not cooking like that every day. So I'm spoiling him. So, you know, my father-in-law, well, I'm just trying to get him fat as hell right now, because he gonna lose weight when we leave. Anyway, so, you know, so he been doing a lot of cooking. Now, I must say this, they eat rice every night. Black people cannot eat rice every night. Hell, they're trying to make me a diabetic. You understand what I'm trying to tell you? So, but anyway, I'm loving the food and everything, man. And I'm just loving my Puerto Rican family, man. Everything is going good. Now, with this whole coronavirus thing going on, I hear a lot of Black people talking, old Black people talking about coronavirus. And old Black people never get things right. They were like, you know what? I was talking to my aunt, right? She like, you know that Karen Nova? That Karen Nova, that Karen Nova putting people down. I'm like, auntie, what is Karen Nova? That Karen Nova, that's how, you know that Karen Nova? I'm like, are you talking about coronavirus? Whatever, it's called Karen Nova. Well, I'm kind of wrong. You understand me? So old Black people can't never get nothing right. Now, it's gonna be a lot of kids being made during this quarantine. So a lot of kids gonna be coming to be born 9 months later. They're gonna be called coronavirus babies. Now it's gonna be some Black people, God bless them, that's gonna name their kids coronavirus.
C-Y-R-U-S.
You know what, they're gonna spell it different. You know, coronavirus.
With a K.
R-U-S. Black people, because you know, Black people always name their babies according to the times or what have you. You understand me? A lot of people finding out whether they have good marriages or not nowadays. When you got to spend all this time with your significant other, and every morning you look up and you're like, you know what? I really don't like you. You now know you have a problem in your marriage. When your wife looking at you like, when you going back to work? Because you throwing everything off here at the house. You understand me? That's not happening in my home. I'm so happy to be here. My wife's
that's she's great. Scared.
Continue yeah. on. You understand? Yeah. I do know what, yeah, anyway,
that for legal
I
don't want purposes. To
back into that, but anyway. But everything is going good, man. I'm having a ball here with my family, man. Got my son here. I am so happy to have my son, Percy Cruz, the third. Call him PC3, baby. He's the
P-Tray.
PC3, P-Tray. He's the next generation putting it down, you know, producing beats and stuff like that and rapping. You know, that's what they do. You know what I'm talking about? I'd be trying to play like what she was singing, some Gladys Knight and some Aretha Franklin and some Ray Charles. I love Ray Charles. You know, I'm just going to try to make a good. You know what I mean? I love me some Ray Charles, man. But Anyway, man, it's always a pleasure to be here with my big brother, Marcus Anthony. He's 97. He looks good.
Listen, it's good to have you here. It's good to have everyone here. And I hope that the people, I know that the people that are watching this Facebook Live enjoyed themselves. Once again, I just want everybody to, Azeem, go ahead, tell us about your show once again. Tell us what's going on in your life. We're going to get ready to get out of here. I want to go through and give everybody a plug once again.
Y'all can just follow me at Azeem Comedy. You know, we'll have potato salad and baked beans without pork in them because I can't do that. I just want to thank everybody for being on here. Marcus, thank you for having me.
Thank you.
No, thank you, sir. You know, it's always a wonderful thing to be with you and have some more fun. Everybody was amazing. So I'm glad to have met you guys.
Excellent.
Yes, well, my show is called Stand Up Radio. No, Stand. That ain't naming the other
what
guy.
The other name is. Al ain't got no show.
A Stand Up Guy Radio. And we are every Saturday live, 8:30.
Excellent. Excellent.
On Facebook.
Ben.
Yeah, so I'll tell you what, I invested in like 500 DVDs. To sell on cruise ships.
Oh.
All happened. So I have this killer DVD set that teaches 10 magic tricks that anybody can do, ages 6 to 106. Normally I would sell them for like $25, but if you guys friend me on Facebook, anybody who's watching, I'll send it to you for $10. Just Ben Nemzer, BenNemzer. Find me on Facebook. Or if you guys have a company that wants like a virtual show or something, hit me up, but just find me on Facebook, guys.
Excellent. Alyssa.
Yes. Yes. Thank you so much, Marcus, for having me. I absolutely adore you. And thank you guys are so awesome. It's nice virtually meeting everyone. Hopefully we'll get to work together in the future. My new EP, it's available on all streaming platforms, Spotify, Pandora, Apple Music, iTunes, all of those. It's called Wild Dreamer by Alyssa Harris. And you can also find it on my website, which is alyssaharrismusic.com. So thank you.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Excellent. B-Dog, Percy.
What's happening with you, baby? What's happening with you? How come my picture not like everybody else's when you put her up, put everybody else's picture up, but my picture don't up on the thing. Can you click on me? That's Alyssa. I see Alyssa, but I Where's don't my... see me. How come I don't ever see my damn picture in my video when I come up? What is wrong? I told you he's my older brother, your 100 years. Anyway. y'all holler at me, man. Go to Percy Cruz 2, man, on Facebook, man. Go to PercyCruz2.com. Holler at me. You understand what I'm saying? And also, man, y'all look for me in movies or sitcoms or whatever. I'm doing a lot of auditioning and stuff like that. I have an agent, so I'm doing a lot of auditioning for those type of things, man. So y'all look for me. I'm coming up on the big screen or the little screen or what have you, anybody's screen. I'm not on this screen because my older brother, who's 127, do not know how to put me on the screen. And for some people that made some comments, Shannon Edwards, he said, I don't speak for all Black people. He eat rice all the time, but he's living up in Canada with white folks. So he developed white folks.
white folk syndrome.
You understand what I'm saying? You know what I mean? And my wife, when I said, not us, she says, you better be kidding. I am kidding, but I love you very much. Anyway, y'all have me, baby. Percy Cruz, 2 all day, every day. You hear me?
Hey, so family, friends, Cruz fam, I want to thank all of our guests for joining us. I want to thank you all for watching and getting some laughs and enjoying some good music. You all take care of each other. It's a beautiful day, no matter what the weather is like, no matter what we're going through. You have to think it through in positive thoughts and bring joy into your day. I thank you all once again for watching. Check us out next Tuesday.
Can I say one more thing?
What?
I just want to say, like Carnival says, she's going to try to ignore me. You hear me? I just asked a boy, he's going to try to ignore me.
Why you gonna ignore me? I'm trying to tell you he's 137. But like I said, like Carnival says, ladies and gentlemen, we will be back. Holla.
Yes, we will. Absolutely. But for now, we're gonna go. So take it.
Something else. Say something else.
Say I learned something today that eating rice is a white syndrome.
I didn't know that before today.
Oh, no. Wow. You got it.
See, I told you. Look at Ben. Look at Ben.
What are you talking about? I don't understand what you're talking about.
Yeah. Oh, you guys take care. Blessings.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, Marcus. Care, bye, everyone.
You well.
Bye-bye.
Bye.